I think, I mean, I've been to, it's been award season, so I've been to quite a few since the beginning of the year. And I think this one, say for our award, so it's Best TV Drama, it celebrates every single department from lighting, music, acting, it's everything across the board. And it's exciting to be a part of a whole group of the arts rather than just specifics. So it just feels a bit more inclusive, and it's a special awards. I think that it's been so popular because every single aspect of the show created something brilliant. I think there was a tense thriller aspect, and that is down to our DPs. It's down to the cinematography. It's down to the writing. It's down to how we portray it as the actors. I just think that everything came together, and that doesn't happen very often with scripts. Scripts can be good, but to take off like Dr. Foster did, it's like once in a while, as far as I'm concerned. And yeah, it was a special job.
For you, what was the most challenging part of the emotional gauntlet that your character runs through?
Well, Mike Bartlett's writing is so brilliant that because I was the lead character, but also I got to play Gemma in the moment. Gemma, the woman who was figuring out the affair. Gemma, who had to be the doctor, who had to be the wife, who had to be the mother. So what this part did for me was I got to play a range of emotions, which, you know, sometimes you just don't get to. You play one character. So there was all sorts to play within this role. I think I do a programme called Scott and Bailey as well, and when we did that 5 years ago, there wasn't a lot of dramas for female characters. But now I think it's different. I think there's a lot more complex characters, complex writing for female roles, and it's got much better.
What does it mean for you not just to be part of this ceremony, but to be one of our lovely nominees?
It's very flattering, and I can't claim too much credit. I'm one of a big gang who are here to be recognised for Dr. Foster, which is, as all of these things are, a big collaboration. But I shall lurk in the background and take up more than my fair share of praise. Anyway, how does it feel? Well, it's a beautiful sunny day, so it's a shame to be indoors. But if you had to be indoors, being in the Savoy drinking champagne and hobnobbing with posh folks like this is, you know, it could be worse, eh? I think people recognise what the story's about and those experiences. It's probably nearer to most people than most people would like. Infidelity is a story that touches most people's lives at some point or other, I'd say, and I think it's means it has a universal appeal, but frankly, nobody knows anything in terms of why things are successful, do they? Otherwise, we'd all be doing it time and time again. So I suppose because it was unusual, and I think Mike Bartlett, who wrote it, has an incredible eye for life and an ability to make characters speak in a way that's true to life, and I think the acting was fantastic. I really enjoy working with Suranne. She's incredibly professional and incredibly thorough. But at the end of the day, acting's about an instinct, and she has a killer instinct. She's got a sharp instinct for character, and totally believable. I've always felt very comfortable with her as a sort of acting partner, as it were, because we can just spar or riff or jam, you know, it's like playing music, or maybe it's like boxing, I don't know. But she's the real deal.
What's coming up for you in the future? What are you working on right now?
I'm directing a play called Strife at Chichester Festival Theatre in the Minerva, which we go into rehearsals in July. So I've spent most of the last, certainly the last 6 months, and actually much of the last year preparing that. So it's a big departure for me, my first time as a director. So it's a really growthful, wonderful, it's a fantastic play. Everybody should come and see it. So that's a really exciting departure for me.